Recent high-profile cases of white police officers killing unarmed blacks have been making headlines across the country. The issue has sparked national outrage and prompted protests and calls for justice. But many point out that, like every other profession, there are good police officers and bad ones. Joining us via Skype to talk about the issue is Mike Dye of Christian Law Enforcement Resources. Thanks for joining us, Mike.
Thank you, Charlene. It's good to be here.
Thank you. Well, first of all, tell us a little bit about your organization.
Our ministry is a nationwide ministry. It's part of the Fellowship of Christian Peace Officers, which is a nationally recognized 501(c) organization. We have officers, thousands of police officers throughout North America, to include Canada, and even some countries overseas. The goal is to reach Christian officers to be that shining example toward other Christian officers while on the job. As you know, this job is extremely difficult, and we need to have strong Christian officers who can uplift, encourage, and be a morale booster for officers in this line of work.
Excellent. Well, you've been in law enforcement for a number of years, and you mentioned how tough it is to be an officer. Talk a little bit about how hard it is to be an officer now.
Well, you know, we bring it up to 2015. Things are real tough right now. Law enforcement is discouraged. Morale is down throughout the country among police officers that I've spoken with. I myself have been in law enforcement for over 30 years now, and I've never seen anything like this. You know, as a spirit-filled evangelical Christian, Charlene, I look for biblical answers. And one that comes to mind is Matthew 24:12, which states, "In the final days, lawlessness will abound." And I think we're seeing that, maybe on both sides of the issue.
Wow. Well, we have seen some pretty negative press about police officers lately. What are your thoughts on what's been making headlines?
It's not good on both sides of the issue. I've looked at it, talked to people on both sides of the issue and trying to understand this, and it's not good. And it's a difficult time, you know. It's a difficult time to be a police officer, too. Snap judgments we have to make in law enforcement. Couple that with the amount of technology that's out there today. I think some of this has gone on for years. It's just that now, today, we have it instantaneously.
Well, no doubt, Mike, there are good officers and there are bad ones. Talk about that.
Yeah, there's no doubt. Just like in any position, any job, you have good people and you have bad people. And that's one of the goals of our ministry, is to encourage and bring out closeted Christians, if you will, in law enforcement, and bring them out into the open so that we can say, look, there's nothing wrong with being both a cop and a Christian. And thereby, if we can do that, we'll weed out those bad law enforcement officers. But in any job, you're going to have both good and bad. Even in churches, pastors make bad decisions. You know, when the devil wants to get at a church, he goes after a pastor. It could be a corruption issue. It could be a prostitution issue. It could be an extramarital affair. But if the devil wants to take out a church, he will take out the pastor. And I think we're seeing some of that with law enforcement. You know, take out your first line defenses and you've got nothing.
But we know that there are a lot of good officers out there, and you actually host a Bible study for police officers. Tell us about that.
Yes. Back in 2005, a Bible study God laid on my heart called The Peacekeepers came out, and it's been an encouragement to officers. It takes real-life scenarios that officers can appreciate, working with difficult supervisors, stress on the job, working too much overtime, all these things that officers encounter on a daily basis, and thereby relating specific scripture back to those scenarios so that officers can understand them. And wow, Charlene, God is good. I've got good feedback throughout the years how that book has impacted officers and brought more officers to Christ.
Praise God for that. Well, Mike, how can Christians pray for those in law enforcement?
Well, we need you to pray. We definitely. Romans 13 talks about the authority, and that we need you to pray that law enforcement officers are, one, protected, that, two, that they can lead other law enforcement officers to Christ, the stronger Christians can, And again, I mentioned it earlier, if we can also pray that the Christian officers will step forward to take a role in this. Sometimes, Charlene, we get in this business this macho attitude, and we think it's going to be soft to be a Christian, but it's really not. You know, when you have the Lord on your side, you can do you can accomplish great things, as you know.
Amen. Mike Dye, thank you so much for your service, and thank you for joining us today. God bless you.
Thank you.